Hello everyone. In this we will discuss module 3, in that principles of measurements will be covered in this lecture. Myself Deepashri AP. So here we can see the complete syllabus of module 3. Already I have done a video on the inverters, and now I will move on to the principles of measurement, where we will be discussing about the static characteristic, errors, and multi-range ammeters, voltmeter, and all. Principles of measurement, characteristics of measurement. To choose one most suited to a particular measurement application, we have to know the system characteristic. Like to choose the required quantity. So to choose the measuring device, we should know the behavior of the device, how it reacts to the environment, or how variation will take place, what are the characteristic of those device. All these things should be known. The performance characteristic may be broadly divided into static and dynamic characteristic. Now, static characteristic, the performance criteria for the measurement of quantities that remain constant or vary only quite slowly. That is, the quantities remains constant and it varies very slowly, quite slowly. That is, very slowly. Such type of quantities, characteristics, we call it as static characteristics. Such type of performance criteria of the measurement, we call it as static characteristic. Next is dynamic characteristic. In this, the relationship between the system input and the output when the measured quantity is varying rapidly, like it will be, there will be a rapid change, very fast changes, or variation, and that is the relationship between input and output will be very soon, rapid change will occur. Such type of characteristic we call it as dynamic characteristic. Coming to accuracy, this is closeness with which the measuring instrument can measure the true value of the measurement under stated conditions of use, that is its ability to tell the truth. We can say it is the closeness to which an instrument can read the true or actual value of the quantity or variable being measured. The accuracy of an instrument is quantified by the difference of its readings and the one given by ultimate or primary standard. Next is precision. Precision is defined as the ability of the instrument to reproduce a certain set of readings within given accuracy. How precisely it produces the output, that is about the precision. That is, if we do the same experiment, how often we are getting the same result, that will be the precision. Precision describes an instrument's degree of random variation in its output when measuring a constant quantity. Precision depends upon repeatability. Same experiment is conducted several times and observe the result. If repeatedly you are getting the almost same result, we can say the device is precise. Next is repeatability. Repeatability is defined as the ability of the instrument to reproduce a group of measurement of the same measured quantity made by same observer using same instrument under same condition. Like it is defined as the ability of the instrument to produce a group of same measured quantity by the same observer using same instrument under the same conditions. Such type of measuring we call it as repeatability. Instrument. So a device or mechanism used to determine the present value of the quantity and a measurement. That is about the instrument. An electronic instrument works on electrical or electronic principles for its measurement. Now, what is measurement? It is a process of determining the amount or degree or capability or capacity by comparison with accepted standards of the system units being used. Resolution. Smallest change in the measurement to which the instrument will respond. Like for example, by giving 5 volt input, we got the 10 volt as the output. But if I give 5.1 volt, corresponding change should be there. Like for 5.1, that is a 0.1 changes in the input, the instrument should respond and output should get 10.5 volt. That is the resolution. A smallest change in the measurement to which the instrument will respond. Sensitivity. The ratio of change in output of the instrument to the change in input or measured variable. So sensitivity is a ratio that is from of change in output of the instrument to the change in input. So change in output by change in input is the sensitivity. Expected value. Most probable value that the calculation indicate. Error. The deviation of the value from the desired value. Errors in measurement. Measurement is the process of comparing unknown quantity with the standard quantity. Measurement obtained we call as true value or expected value. The degree of which measurement nears the expected value of the variable or measured value of the variable. So to calculate the error, we can see that E is the error and E is given by Yn minus Xn. E is the absolute error and Yn is the expected value, Xn is the measured value. Then percentage error is given by absolute value divided by expected value into 100. That is absolute value is E divided by Yn into 100. Therefore, percentage error equal to E, I can rewrite as Yn minus Xn divided by Yn into 100. It is more frequently expressed as accuracy rather than the error. Therefore, A is given by A equal to, for accurate, A is the relative accuracy. So, A is equal to 1 minus Yn minus Xn divided by Yn, mod of Yn, that is 1 minus mod of Yn minus Xn divided by Yn, where A is the relative accuracy. Accuracy is expressed as a percentage accuracy and A is equal to 100% minus percentage error. That is A equal to A into 100%, where A is the percentage accuracy. Types of error. Gross error. These errors are mainly due to the human mistakes in reading or in using instruments or errors in recording observation. Error may also occur due to incorrect adjustment of the instrument and computational mistakes. These errors cannot be treated mathematically. Systematic error. That is, under the types of error, we have three. That is, gross error, systematic error, random error. Gross error is mainly due to human errors, adjusting of the instruments and improper observation, mathematical calculation mistakes. All this comes under gross. Now, systematic error. These errors occur due to shortcomings of the instrument, such as defective or worn part or aging or effect of the environment on the instrument. Like the instrument changes when the temperature changes in such case, or instrument aging effect means instrument is of so many years back, it has been manufactured, and the variation due to that. These errors are sometimes referred to as bias, and they influence all measurements of the quantity alike. A constant uniform deviation of the operation of an instrument is known as systematic error. These errors are due to the wear and tear, aging of parts. Equipment also will be affected by the environment. So there are basically three types of systematic errors, that is instrument, second one is environmental, and third is observational. The first one, instrumental error. Instrumental errors are inherent in measuring instrument because of their mechanical structure. It can be avoided. The steps to avoid this error, that is selecting a suitable instrument for the particular measurement application, applying correction factor and determining the amount of instrumental error, calibrating the instrument against a standard. So by using these three methods, we can avoid the instrument error. Next is environmental error. These errors are due to the conditions external to the measuring devices, including conditions in the area surrounding the instruments, such as effects of change in temperature, humidity, barometric pressure, or of magnetic or electrostatic fields. These errors can also be avoided by air conditioning, hermetically sealing certain components in the instrument, and using magnetic shields. So these are the methods to avoid environmental error. The last one is observational error. Observation errors are errors introduced by the observer. For example, in the analog multimeter and all, we have to observe the values from the straight distance, so that we will get a accurate value. If we observe from the side view, if it is in side view, then the value varies. So such type of errors we call it as observational errors. Observational errors are the errors introduced by the observer. The most common error is the parallax error introduced in reading a meter scale. The error of the estimation when obtained is obtained a reading from a meter scale. These errors are caused by the habitat of individual observer. For example, an observer may always introduce an error by consistently holding his head too far to the left while reading a needle and scale reading. Random errors. These are errors that remain after gross and systematic error have been substantially reduced or at least accounted for. Random errors are generally an accumulation of large number of small effects and may be of real concern only in the instruments requiring a high degree of accuracy. Such errors can be analyzed statically. These errors are due to unknown causes, non-determinable in the ordinary process of making measurements. Such errors are normally small and follow the law of probability. Random errors can thus be treated mathematically. Source of errors. Source of errors, other than the inability of a piece of hardware to provide a true measurement, are as follows: insufficient knowledge of process parameter and design condition, poor design, change in process parameter, irregularities, upset, etc., poor maintenance, error caused by the person operating the instrument or equipment, certain design limitations. So these are the causes or the source for the error. multi-range ammeter. What is this ammeter? Why it is used for? Ammeter is mainly used to measure the current. So current range of the DC ammeter can be extended by using number of shunt resistors. Here we can see that shunt resistors and a selected range switch. Such ammeter is called a multi-range ammeter, and it consists of R1, R2, R3, R4 are the four shunt resistors connected in parallel with the meter. They can give four different ranges, that is I1, I2, I3 and I4. So this is the circuit for the multi-range ammeter. Now here in this circuit we can see a selector switch. Yes, it is a multi-position switch. Multi-position switch having low contact resistance and high current carrying capacity. The make before break type switch is used for the range changing. So make before break, this type of switch is used. If the ordinary switch is used while range changing, the switch remains open. That is, while range changing, the switch may remain open and full current passes through the meter. So there is a possibility of full current passing through the meter if ordinary switch is used. The meter may get damaged due to this such high current. So make before break switch is used. The design of such switch is so that it makes contact with next terminal before completely breaking the contact with the previous terminal. That is the advantage of make before break. That is, the switch used is make before break. Like it will not leave completely before making, it will having partial contact with this. When this leaves, when this want to switch to R2, so that it will protect the meter. Here we can see the same thing over here what we discussed. You can just go through that. Next topic is multi-range voltmeter. Now what is voltmeter? Voltmeter is used to measure the voltage. And multi-range voltmeter, we can see the two figures. That is, one is connected in parallel and other is in connected in series. As in the case of ammeter, to obtain a multi-range ammeter, a number of shunts are connected across the movement with a multi-position switch. Similarly, in case of DC voltmeter, it can be converted into multi-range voltmeter by connecting a number of resistors along with the range switch to provide a greater number of workable ranges. The multipliers are connected in a series string, and the range selector selects the appropriate amount of resistance required in series with the movement. This arrangement is advantageous compared to the previous one. Like connecting in series is advantageous because all multiplier resistances except the first, we have the standard resistance value and are also easily available in precision tolerances. The first resistor or low range multiplier R4 is the only special resistor which has to be specially manufactured to meet the circuit requirement. So the same thing is discussed over here. Please refer my blog for the PPTs. The blog is Explore Electronics and the path is given. And please do subscribe my YouTube channel and press press bell icon for the further updates. Keep watching. Thank you.